Hey Canucks fans, welcome to Week at a Glance, where I look back at the week that was and I look ahead at the week to come. I'm Canuck Clay, I'm the founder of the GLCPC, the good-looking Canucks Positivity Club, and if you're new, here's what you should do. Hit the subscribe button now for daily Canucks insight that's positive, timely, and trustworthy. And as always, this vlog is brought to you by Van City Experts Real Estate Group. Contact Jason Lim and his team for all of your real estate needs, and by Perform and Transform, personal training and weight loss. Sign up now for a free 7-day trial using the link in my video descriptions. It was a pretty awesome week. Couldn't have gotten any better. The Canucks went 4-0 under the tutelage, under the guidance, the direction of their new head coach, Bruce Boudreau. And yes, also during the week, they announced Jim Rutherford as the new president of hockey operations. But let's focus on what happened on the ice. I talk about off-ice stuff all the time in my vlogs. For a week at a glance, let's focus on what happened on the ice. So the Canucks went 4-0, and I actually predicted they went 3-1, so I was pretty close, actually. On Monday, the Canucks shut out the LA Kings 4-0 in a very dominant performance at home, a 4-0 win. I predicted a 4-2 win, so I was a little bit off. I got the 4 right, but the Canucks start the week off really well on the Monday night. I was at that game with my lovely wife, Gail. Then on Wednesday, and that was the first game of the Bruce Boudreau era. Then on Wednesday, the Canucks beat the Boston Bruins 2-1 in a shootout. That was the one where, in that game, the Canucks went up early. Well, they got the first goal. It was Miller on a power play. Then it was Boston on a power play in a similar deflection goal. And then the Vancouver Canucks won it in the shootout after a so-so overtime. But that was the one where Pettersson missed, but both Miller and Horvat scored on their shootout attempts. So a 2-1 victory for the Canucks. I actually predicted a 3-2 victory, so I was pretty close, one goal off for each team. Then on Friday, that crazy back-and-forth 4-3 shootout victory over Winnipeg. A lot of defensive blunders, a lot of breakaways, a very exciting overtime period, and then capped off by Petey scoring the only goal in the extra frame. The Canucks won 4-3 in the shootout. I actually predicted a 5-3 victory for the Canucks, so that one I was actually very close on the score. And then Sunday night, the Canucks beat one of the top teams in the league in the Carolina Hurricanes, scored the first two goals, hung on for the 2-1 victory. Thatcher Demko, as he was in all the games this week, played really well. In fact, he was the first star for the NHL for the entire week. Canucks win 2-1. This is the one I admit that I predicted at the start of the week that Carolina would win 3-1, so I was completely off. But actually, in my prediction of the day, I actually changed it to Carolina. So all to say, I went four. The Canucks went 4-0. I went 3-1. The week before that, the Canucks went 2-1, and I went 2-1 in my predictions. So in the last 2 weeks, the Canucks have won 6 out of 7, and I've gone 6 out of 7 in my predictions. Not too shabby. So let's set up now the week that's about to come. Tonight, the Vancouver Canucks go for their 5th straight win, their 7th victory in their last 8 games, and they're hosting the Columbus Blue Jackets. Now, whereas the Canucks, we know that they are 12-15-2 for 26 points in 29 games, and they have a home record of 7-7-1, so 500, and an away record of 5-8-1. Let's look at Columbus. They entered the game with 29 points in 26 games, so they're the opposite. We are 26 points in 29, they're 29 in 26, so they're obviously a better team than we are there, but they're not so good on the road. They're 5-8, and they're only 4-5-1 in their last 10 games, whereas the Canucks are 6-4, buoyed by that 4-game win streak. Now, when you look at Columbus, they're not the highest scoring team, that's for sure. And their high scorers are Oliver Bjorkstrand and Jacob Voracek, 23 points and 22 points, then a bit of a depth, then Boone Jenner and Zach Werenski. And those are the only have 4 players who have over 15 points this season. So I'm expecting, you know, a defensive battle a little bit. Not the highest scoring game because the Columbus Blue Jackets do have some really good goaltending. But I'm going to predict a Canucks win. I'm going to predict that they move to 5 straight wins. So I'm going with a 3-2 victory over the Columbus Blue Jackets. Then on Thursday night, the Canucks is weird. What a weird schedule. After a 7-game homestand or 6-game homestand, then they pop down to San Jose for one game only on the Thursday. By the way, it was a 6-game homestand. Yeah, so they go down to San Jose on Thursday to take on the San Jose Sharks. Now, the Sharks are ahead of us in the Pacific Division, but not by much, actually. They have 31 points in 28 games. We have 26 points in the 29 games. So they are 5 points better with one game in hand. And they don't score a lot of goals either, actually. They score even fewer goals than Columbus does. And the Sharks are 7-5-1 at home. We are 5-8-1 at home. So almost identical records, just opposite home and away. And the Canucks, the Sharks have won, they're 6-4 in their past 10 as well. Timo Meier having a really good season. He leads the Sharks scoring with 28 points. Then Logan Couture at 24 points. Thomas Hertl at 20. And then Erik Karlsson at 18. So those are their highest scorers. And I think this game, this is a game where, although the Sharks are ahead of the Canucks in the standings, I really think that this is a game that the Canucks can win. Now, you're looking at the players for San Jose. They're just okay. Timo Meier is playing really well, and they got some offensive firepower, but I do think that the Canucks can take this game. And it's kind of weird because I have a bit of concern because it's just a one-game, one-off, but it's the first road game under Bruce Boudreau, and if I think the Canucks are going to beat Columbus, I think they can beat San Jose and make it 6 wins in a row. It sounds crazy to say that, but it's very possible. And I'm going with a low scoring game just because it's away. So I'm going 2-1 Vancouver. So I got 3-2 over Columbus, then 2-1 over San Jose. Then the Canucks come back for a couple home games, and they start off against the mighty Toronto Maple Leafs. Now, Toronto is tied for the top of the NHL with 40 points in 29 games. So we have 26 points in 29 games. Toronto has 40 points in 29 games. They can put the puck in the net. They're also getting good goaltending, and they're 7-4-1 away, and they're coming in 7-2-1 in their last 10. So this is a good team. Auston Matthews, 31 points. John Tavares, 31 points. William Nylander, 30 points. So those guys are scoring at more than a point a game pace. Then you have Morgan Rielly as the top D-man at 24 points and Mitch Marner with 21. So you got guys that are scoring at a very, very high clip. You guys have like Auston Matthews and John Tavares also dominating in the faceoff circle. So I admit, this is going to be a tough game for the Vancouver Canucks. It's an early start, 4 p.m., and I know there's going to be a lot of Maple Leafs fans going to that game. I'm going to that game. And as much as I hate to say this, I think that Toronto is going to beat Vancouver, handing Bruce Boudreau his first loss. And I think this is going to be a high-scoring one, relatively speaking, so I'm going to go 4-3 Toronto. But the Canucks will no rest for the wicked, so to speak. The very next night, they're hosting the pitiful Arizona Coyotes. Arizona will, at least to start off this week, they are 5-20-2. That's right, they have 12 points in 27 games. Pitiful 3-11-1 away, 3-7 in their last 10. They've lost 5 straight games as I record this. And you look at their highest scores. Remember, they played 27 games. Their highest score is defenseman Shane Gothersburg at 17 points, along with Clayton Keller. Good name, but Clayton Keller with 17 points. And then Phil Kessel with 15 points. Isn't that crazy? That's their high scores. By the way, I see Travis Boyd with 10 points in 20 games. Not sure how that happened. Looking at the other ex-Canucks, you see Anton Roussel with 4 in 23, Louis Erickson with 4 in 25, and Jay Beagle with 1 point in 21. So I'm not too worried about the ex-Canucks coming back to haunt the Canucks. I think they're going to bounce back after a loss against Toronto, and I think they're going to win quite handily. I think they're going to beat the Arizona Coyotes 4-1. So if everything goes well, at least if everything goes according to my predictions, the Canucks will go 3-1 this week. They'll beat Columbus 3-2 on Tuesday at home. They'll beat San Jose in San Jose on Thursday 2-1. They'll come back and they'll lose at home to Toronto 4-3. But then the very next night on Sunday, they will at home beat Arizona 4-1. So those are my score predictions. I'd love to know how you think the Canucks will do this week. Give me how many wins they're going to get out of the 4 games. And if you want, throw in some score predictions as well. Shout out to my new legend tier, my new legendary members, legendary Lucas Gates and legendary Andrew Chang, hero members, Nux Fan number 29, and Justin Credible. Hall of Fame members, Gens 95, Sim Alexander, Chris Seifert, Adam Broomfield, Shannon Hollingworth, Carol Bovenlander, and HSM Fangirl Gaming, and to franchise and all-star members as well. Thanks to all of you. I appreciate your support. I do not take you for granted. And if you want to become a member of the CCC crew, or if you want to upgrade your membership, press the join button underneath this or in my videos or in the memberships tab on my YouTube channel. Subscribe if you'd like to. Like this video if you'd like to. Become a member of this channel if you'd like to. Leave a comment down below if you'd like to with your predictions on the Canucks record for these next four games, three of them at home. Can the Canucks keep their hot streak going? I sure hope so. And I'm releasing this video at 8:30 in about half an hour. You'll start to see everything on social media about a brand new initiative that Marie Huey and I are doing. We are on Cameo and we will be doing Christmas songs and Christmas messages for fans, $50 US, but all the proceeds going to charity, going to the Canucks for Kids Fund. So if that interests you, look across all my social media later today and you'll see how you can find us on Cameo, or just go to cameo.com/Marie and Clay. Okay, friends, stay safe, stay healthy, take care of yourselves and take care of each other. Have a great day, and I'll check in with you later with the game preview for tonight's game, Canucks hosting the Columbus Blue Jackets. God bless, and go Canucks, go.